Hi everyone. Today I'll be teaching you how I make my bustier tub. But first let me show you how I take my measurements. So I start with the mannequin this way. I put my tape on the collarbone straight down to the nipple, which I call my center. Still on the collarbone, I take it straight down to under the bust, which I call my below. Still from the collarbone, I take it to the navel, which I call my frontal length. Also from the collarbone, I take it straight down to the preferred top length, which I call my blouse length. Then I go across the bust. From the nipple point here to this here, I call it my breast point. You must always take this measurement because it's very important. And after that, I go across the armpits and measure this way. I call it my tube. I go across the breast also, which you all call breast, obviously. And I go across the underbust this way, which I call my underbust. Then the waist, I call it the waist as well. Right on the preferred top length, which I call the blouse half length, this way. And I go to the back of the client or the back of the mannequin. From one shoulder point here to the other shoulder point here, I call it the back or the shoulder. Also from the collarbone, I take it straight down to the low back, which I call my back half length. So after this measurement is taken, the next step is to draft a pattern. So I'm about to show you how I draft pattern for my bustier top. The first thing I do is I take out 3-inch measurement here and I chuck it. Then I go to my center. My own measurement is written here. My center is 10. My below is 14. The front half length is 18. And the blouse length is 21. I'll include 1 inch for seam allowance, which is here. After that, I roll out the chalk part. The next step is to chalk my breast points. The measurement I have here for my preferred breast point is 8. I'll divide 8 into 2, which will give me 4. How did I get these measurements? I picked the biggest part of my measurements. I divide into 2. The biggest part of my measurement here is 7. I divide into 2. That will give me 18 and a half. 18 and a half into 2 is half of what I have here. So this here is 18 and a half. So I'll come here. I'll chalk my 4 inches. And I include my seam allowance, which is 1/2 inch. You can do 1 inch, you can do 1/2 inch, depends on your preferred seam allowance. And the next step is to come here. I'm going to use 3 inches. I'll take out 1 inch from the 4 inches I have here. This is in here. I'll include my seam allowance, which is 1. And the next part is to go to the length of the top here also, which is 3 inches. Then I include my seam allowance, which is 1/2 inch. Then I come here to the edge. This is the upper part. This is the bottom part. 3 inches here. Then I include my seam allowance, which is 1 inch. So the next thing to do is to join my dots together. That's first. Then I come here. I measure 2.5. This is a standard measurement I use for my own breast cut. And I join my dot also here. And I come back here. Same 2.5 inches I used here is applied to this place as well. I chalk. And I join my dots together. So the next step is to rule this way. I hope you are with me. After doing that, then I come to the bottom of the top here. The distance from here, which is the top length, and this point should be 2.5. Mind you, this is not included because this is the seam allowance. Then I join my dots. Please watch how I do that. This way. Okay. Then I measure the accurate measurement here. Here I have bust as 38. Half of 38 is 19. And half of 19 is 9 1/4. I come here. I measure my 9 1/4. Now include 2 extra inches for seam allowance. Same thing I do for the underbust. I chalk my underbust, include 2 inches seam allowance. Also, for the blouse hip, this is my measurement here, and I include my 2 inches seam allowance. Then I join my dots together. So, after trimming the bottom parts of the blouse length, you can label patch if you want to, and if you don't want to, you can leave it as well. But the next thing I'll do after trimming the length is to cut out the breast cup. This way. Then, we'll cut out the second one also. This is the image trimmed out of the front. After doing that, how I do mine, I place it on each other this way, just to cross-check if everything is balanced. But looking at this, it's not so equal, so I'm have to trim a little bit. This is... how I cut the back of a bustier top. So remember that in the front, I remove 3 inches sewing allowance. The next thing is to check my sewing allowance from the back. Then I trace my back half length. My measurement here for my back half length is 14.5. I'll check my back half length, 14.5. Then I'll check my top length, which is 21. I'll also include my seam allowance, which is 1 inch for the length. After doing that, I'll go through my measurement again. My breast point is 8, which is the interval from one nipple point to the other. I'm about to roll now. Remember I told you about the side of the blouse, the arc shape, which is 2.5. Don't forget, it's very important. Do that. Leave it there. Next thing to do is to get the back half length. Back half length here is 14.5. Then you make sure you get the zip allowance. My zip allowance is 2 inches. This is my zip allowance. After that, my breast point allowance. Because the breast point interval applies to the back of the cloth too. So this way, I'll chalk 4, which is my breast point. I'll include 1 inch, half inch rather, as the same allowance. So now, if I measure from here to here, it gives me 6. Then I'm ready to join my dots. Interval here was 2.5. Same thing applies to the back as well. So half of 2.5 is what you're going to use here. But in this case, you make yours 3 inches. So you have 1.5 here, 1.5 here. As right on the low back that I told you when we were doing our measurements. Please watch. Then I join my dots. So this is the sketch for the back that we've both measured together. Right now, after all is done, like I said for the front piece, you can either label it or not. Depends on how fast you understand. But for this is a label back for a bustier cut. So I'm about to trim out the back now. But after all is done, here I have the front part of the bustier cuts, and here I have the back part of the bustier cuts. This angle here is what was removed from this point, while this one here is what was removed from this point. So after this, I'm going to show you how to join, how to sew it, how to add your breast cup to the pattern we have here. First, I have my scissors here, my tailor chalk, my seam ripper, my needle, my breast cup. This is very important, so you need to get this before you make any bustier top. It's very, very important. I'm about to join the front part of the bustier top, which is this. From the middle part that I shown you when we were cutting, remember that I told you to include half-inch seam allowance, which mine is half-inch here. From the other side also, half-inch. And I'm about to sew. So you notch here as well. Take the back. Join the back. Don't forget that when we were cutting, I told you about this part to indicate the zip allowance. So, which means you're going to join this part, not the zip allowance. You notch here as well. Very important. After this, join your lining, which I've done. I've joined the back. This is the front. And this is the back also. This is what it looks like after joining. This is what the back looks like after joining. And after this, I'll iron this. Then we'll continue with the shaping. So after the joining of the bustier, the front, the back, and also the lining, the next thing is to iron, which I've done. After ironing, then is to shape out the accurate measurement I need before joining and shaping the bustier top. So when I was teaching you how I do my measurement, remember I told you about below, which is 14. From the measurement when we were cutting, my below was 14. So you pick the 14 here. This is right under the breast cup you've built here. You hold it down. And you take it to the top length. My top length was 19. This is 19. I'll include my sewing seam, which is half inch. Then I go to my bust. My bust is 38. I'll divide the measurement just like I've taught you when we're sketching the pattern. This way. When you're trimming your measurements, this arc part of the top, either an English blouse, for trad, anyone, this arc part is very important. Always include this part because you don't want your top folding at the side. You don't want it having excess at the side. So when you arc it this way, then you're good to be now supposed to cut the shape out. After that, you get your best measurement. From the below, which is 14, you put your taper this way, 6 inches. Depends on how much the client wants to show or how little she wants to show. And put it this way, you chuck it out. Please take note. I have my fabric here, my lining for the front and the back. Then I can draw the sweetheart's neckline. I hope you can see this. Then I'm good to go. I want to cut now. Just the front. Take note. I can include 1/2 inch for sewing allowance. So, this is what we get after cutting it. Then we'll cut the back. So, same thing applies to the back. The only difference is just the zip allowance, which is here. Just like I taught you when we were drafting our sketch. So, you turn, you trim it out. Same exact length. Don't add any extra inch to it. From the side, you trim out. Don't forget to notch back zip sign. Then for the back, for a bustier top or for any kind of top, most time the back is always lower than the front. So You trace the exact armor pattern this way. You lift this up a little bit. Then 2 inches distance from the sweetheart neckline here to this point. This way. You dip in the back. Then you can join your chalk. Please watch. So, this is what I have. I have this. Hope you can see. It is this. Then I have the back as well. This is the back. After this, you join lining together. You join the fabric together. You shape your measurements. After joining, it gives me this. So after this is when I put the breast cord, which I showed you the other time, which is this. So, this way. You get the middle of the breast cord. For those that don't know how to use it at all, you notch the middle. Or you chalk the middle. After that, you open it this way. Can you see? You put it this way, and you come to the machine. So, you stitch just this way. You stitch here too. Don't forget, it's the middle part of the breast cut you consider. And it comes out this way. Then same thing applies to the second one. After doing that, you attach your lining to it. You sew, you include your zip. So this is me fixing my zip to the blouse. I prefer to pull my zip out so that in case of whenever you have a mishap, it's easy to change. So after the sewing, the cutting, the pattern drafting, this is the result. So here's the finished product of the Bustier top. This is the front of the top. And here's the back of the top. I'm sure you've been able to learn a thing or two from me. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.